Throughout our history, humanity has dreamed of taking flight. For generations, we lived out our lives in tribes and villages, then in towns and cities. But we remained grounded, locked to the earth, while we saw birds soar overhead. We remained constrained, migrating slowly while we were cut off from faraway destinations. Today, we are fortunate to live in an era where we can appear on the other side of the globe in hours, with the planet's endless wonders within our reach. This is the story of how airplanes developed into one of the most essential forms of travel, and of how humans finally achieved their dream of taking flight. For thousands of years, most inventors sought to emulate birds as they pondered how humans could fly someday. During the Renaissance era, scientists such as Leonardo da Vinci, Galileo, Galilei, and Isaac Newton crafted a new understanding of the physics and aerodynamics of flying machines. In the late 18th and early 19th centuries, George Kaley created the first designs for flying machines that would eventually develop into modern aircraft. In 1799, he designed a glider that would be flown by his servant almost 50 years later, in what was the first recorded successful manned flight. In 1902, the Wright brothers managed to successfully fly their own glider. They then added an internal combustion engine, and in North Carolina, on December 17, 1903, achieved the world's first sustained powered flight. The Wright brothers inspired a wave of flights across the world, as individual inventors and powerful nations sought to invest in the new frontier of technology. European countries built the first military aircraft, just as World War I broke out a few short years later. Early World War I aircraft were primarily utilized for reconnaissance due to engine limitations of the time. As engine technology improved, aircraft became more specialized and fighters were developed to deny enemies access to airspace. Aviation took a huge leap forward in World War I, with advancements in engine technology, weapons, production methods, and aircraft design. Although airplanes did not play a major role in the direction of the war overall, it was obvious that they were the next frontier of transportation and would be crucial in shaping the lives of humanity over the next century. In the post-war era, daring pilots set records in air travel and began to explore previously remote places. In 1932, Amelia Earhart became the first woman to complete a solo transatlantic flight. 5 years later, she disappeared over the Pacific during an attempt to circumnavigate the globe. Compared to World War I, aviation played a much larger role in the Second World War. When the war began, the US, UK, and Germany were leaders in aviation technology. Among fighters, the British Spitfire and German Bf 109 accounted for most of the early engagements, especially in the Battle of Britain. On the Pacific front, the Japanese Zero fighter was incredibly maneuverable compared to its adversaries, and gave Japan an early edge in aviation combat. However, it was particularly vulnerable to battle damage, and as the war dragged on, newer American fighters, such as the P-51 Mustang, shifted the balance of power to the US. Bombers in World War II played a major role in determining the outcome of the conflict. German Stuka dive bombers were used in the conquest of continental Western Europe, But their success was blunted during the Battle of Britain, since German fighters lacked the range to support them. On the American side, the B-29 Superfortress was the heaviest bomber of the war, and crucial to American bombing campaigns in Germany and Japan. This was the same bomber that dropped atomic weapons on Hiroshima and Nagasaki. Until World War II, virtually all aircraft used piston engines to power propellers and generate lift. In 1939, Germany invented the world's first jet-powered aircraft in the Heinkel HE-178. At the time, piston engine aircraft were close to reaching their performance limits, and jet engines enabled aircraft to produce more power, fly higher, and faster. This was a significant breakthrough in engine technology, and would pave the way for future advancements in aviation over the next few decades. World War II also saw the emergence of helicopters, as they began to be used by Germany for transport and medical evacuation. Their ability to take off and land vertically proved invaluable in situations where a runway was not available. Shortly after the end of the war, Bell Aircraft developed the Bell 47, which became the most popular helicopter model for the next 30 years. After the end of World War II, airplane manufacturers shifted away from producing military aircraft, and the aviation industry started to focus on commercial air travel. Initially, piston-powered airplanes dominated the scene due to their relatively low cost. The Boeing 707's launch in 1957 changed all that and led to the rise of jet aircraft in passenger transport. Boeing followed up their 707 with the even more iconic 747, which first flew in 1969. The first generation 747 doubled the capacity of the 707 and could carry 347 passengers on domestic and transatlantic trips. With five different generations, the 747 stood the test of time and continues to be manufactured even today. However, its reduced fuel efficiency compared to modern airplanes means that 747s are gradually being phased out around the world. Virtually all modern commercial aircraft top out at subsonic speeds of around 650 miles per hour. A joint project between the United Kingdom and France gave rise to the Concorde in 1969, the first civilian supersonic aircraft. Traveling at over twice the speed of sound, it flew from New York to London in a record 2 hours and 53 minutes. The aircraft flew for nearly three decades, but due to a combination of declining ridership after 9/11, high costs, and a fatal accident, it was retired in 2003, drawing the age of supersonic passenger travel to a close. The 60s saw parallel improvements in military aviation as well. The SR-71 Blackbird, a long-range reconnaissance airplane, was introduced in 1966. It traveled at over three times the speed of sound at incredibly high altitudes. The SR-71 was so rapid that standard operating procedure when it encountered a surface-to-air missile was to simply outrun it. The invention of satellites and prohibitively high operating costs led to the SR-71's retirement in the late 1990s. But even today, the SR-71 retains its place in history as the fastest air-breathing operational manned aircraft and traveled at nearly 2,200 miles per hour. Another unique military aircraft developed around the same time as the SR-71 was the Harrier Jump Jet. Introduced in 1969, it combined the takeoff and landing capabilities of a helicopter with the forward speed and range of an airplane. These were a family of jets that could operate from the short decks of aircraft carriers and even in situations where air bases were unavailable. Most versions of the Harrier have been retired, but its legacy lives on in the F-35B, which can also perform a similar short takeoff and vertical landing. The Airbus A380 conducted its first flight in 2005 and became the world's largest passenger airliner. A double-deck aircraft, it typically contains 525 seats, but is certified to carry up to 853 passengers. Although the aircraft was expected to be a success on par with the Boeing 747, the airline industry has shied away from using large jets, significantly dampening interest in A380s. Airbus recently confirmed that production for the A380 will end in 2021. Aircraft today are virtually unrecognizable from the first Wright Brothers machine over a century ago. They are larger, faster, safer, and have revolutionized the world in a way that few thought possible. Aviation is critical to how most of us live our lives, and the future of air travel is something to look forward to. After a long 20-year hiatus, supersonic passenger aircraft may reappear as businesses seek to reduce travel times. Unmanned drones will take over the skies and allow us to transport and receive goods even faster. Airplanes will continue to become more reliable, efficient, and bring the world closer together. It took millennia to get here, but humanity finally achieved its dream of taking flight. Thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video. Feel free to drop a like or leave a comment down below, and subscribe to the channel for more content like this. I'll see everyone in the next video.